Good morning, guys. Welcome back to the Sullivan family. So, it is Bank Holiday Monday. Kids are at home. If you've been following my Instagram, and we have put some on as shorts actually on YouTube, I've been doing hair reels with the younger girls every day. Normally school hair ones, sometimes at the weekend as well. And I've had quite a few people asking for like hair tutorials and stuff. Now, I'm not an expert by any stretch of the imagination, but I do like the girls' hair to look nice. And I like trying out new styles, things like braids and everything. To be honest, I've kind of taught myself everything, how to do everything, and just lots of practice over the years. I probably wasn't as adventurous with the older girls' hair when they were small. They probably just got ponytails quite a lot, to be honest, because I didn't think that I could do all different things and I wasn't necessarily very good at it. But it is just practice. It's practice, practice, practice. I'm lucky that these girls love having their hair done, so they don't mind sitting while I'm practicing. Dutch braids, French braids, I've kind of not actually been able to do them for very long, and my braids aren't anywhere near as neat as Olivia's braids. Olivia does really, really neat braids.
I know how to do braids.
You do, yeah. But I try. So basically, I'm going to do a bit of a hair tutorial. I'm going to start doing some hair tutorial videos, but not tutorial as in the sense of I'm amazing or anything hairdresser wise. Just kind of from a mum. Yeah, I know we do need to get Olivia to do some braids. Just from a mum who is, you know, doing some hairstyles on their kids. And just showing you different ways of doing things. And that's it, really. So I'm going to do one that I've done. I'll show you what I've done on Erin. This is a good thing about having twins. I can show you what it looks like, and then I can show you how to do it. These are things that I look for different styles from other people online. Just Isabel finds reels and stuff that come up, and I think I could probably give that a go. So yeah, follow along and give it a go. That's all I'll say, is give it a go, because sometimes I used to think that I couldn't do all of these different styles, and it's just practice, practice. If your kids especially don't mind you practicing on their hair, just keep practicing. And you know, none of us are perfect, and it doesn't have to be perfect. And I mean, some people, I look at people's hairs, you know, on their kids, and it's amazing. And I think I'll never be able to do it as good as that. But I give it a go. So, you know, that's what's important. So I'll show you Erin. Erin, come over here. It is important to have fun. This is what I've done on Erin's this morning. Turn around. So we've done this. Put your head down a little bit. No, the other way. Backwards. Backwards. Not that far back. There you go. So we've done that on Erin's hair this morning. And I'm going to show you how to do it on Leah's hair. Now just excuse the state of the dining room, because they are in here colouring and cutting and gluing and sticking. And also I am just about to go and clean the bathroom, hence why I look like this, basically. I'm gonna give it a go and show you how to do it. So 1 minute. So I've spoken about this before. I use this argan oil spray, which is, it's actually a heat defense spray. I'll come down so you can see me talking. It's actually a heat defense spray, but it works really well as a detangler, and it smells really nice. And it works really well as like smoothing the hair out. The twins have got a lot of hair, but it's very fine. That's another thing as well. Sometimes you try hairstyles in people's hairs. I keep saying hairs. I can't speak properly this morning. Sometimes you try hairstyles in their hair and don't always work. Like the girls have got, they used to have, well, sometimes they have a side part in, sometimes it kind of, we've trained it a bit more to go into the middle, but they both have a side part in the opposite side originally, and their hair is very fine. So sometimes I see a style and I try it and it doesn't always work, because their hair is actually a lot finer, if it's like a plait or something that needs pulling out, and it's not always thick enough. But you know, it's going to look different in everybody's hair. So I use this just to brush it through, because when they wake up, their hair looks like this. They have it washed. That's my cat. This is my granny's cat. There was two of them. Well, it's not literally my granny's cat, because obviously it's ceramic, but it was my granny's cat. It's very precious, so we leave it there. Yeah, their hair looks like that when they wake up. They have it washed every night and brushed through, but it still looks like that in the morning. So, comb it through, brush it through with this first. This brush is great. I lost the end. I got this from Primark. It was like £2. It's the best brush I've ever had.
Didn't we have that like at Christmas?
Yeah, I went back to get another one, couldn't find them, didn't have them in. Got it. Because we've got loads of brushes and this is the best one.
Do online shopping.
I do online shopping. Right, turn around and brush your hair out. Come back a little tiny bit for me. Squid your bum back, good girl. Right, hang on, let me just put it down a bit because I don't think people can see properly. That's better. Right. Oh no, that was my bracelet. My bracelet keeps falling off.
Don't be too
this
harsh
one
my
keeps
hair.
Falling off.
Don't be too harsh.
Right, so we'll give it a brush through. It does smell nice though, doesn't it, this stuff, Leah?
Yeah.
Don't trip over the stool, Erin. Right, so. As you can see, it kind of just smooths it down. Like that. Right, what you're going to need as well for this. This comb is a bit broken. These ones with the end bit are brilliant for parting and... these tail combs. This is literally the only one I've got. I had more and look, it's all broken. So I've just put in an Amazon order for, I think it was like four. It's got hair in it as well. Four for like a fiver. But the ones with the end bit are the best because they, be careful when they're new, they're sharp.
Sometimes it hurts my head when
you use them. I think Olivia braided their hair once when it was brand new and it is quite sharp. But they're the best for parting. Because if you can get the partings right, which is the bit that I sometimes struggle with, you're laughing. The other thing,
you need
water spray. These bottles, I mean, you can probably get them on Amazon. I get these from Shein. I think this was about £1 or £1.50. Brilliant. They're misting spray bottles because you need water. The other thing, wax stick, Amazon. You can use any hair wax stick. This one's a bit battered because Florence likes to get it out and push it up and push it down and push it up and push it down. It's very annoying.
And she likes to eat it.
Here, we have to take it away from her. Bubbles, hair bubbles. I'm going to use a couple of thick ones.
Like a bucket. Some thin ones.
The little elastics I use quite a lot if I'm doing like a certain style.
What is this?
That's a pull through. I'll show that in a minute. But something like this, the little elastics do get quite stuck in their hair. And where it's long, they do get quite sticky. They're good for some styles not. They're great in Agnes's hair. One of these. Now, I had about five of these. They've all gone missing. I can't remember where I got them from.
There's a black one. Wait.
Yeah, I don't know where it's gone though. But I only need one, so it's fine. I think we got it from Amazon. But it could have been in a pack from Primark. You can pretty much get them anywhere. They're the ones that pull through the ponytails. I'm pretty sure it came from Amazon. So that's what you're going to need for this style. Right, let's go. Come back a bit, tiny bit. Good girl. No, not that far. Right, so what you need to do first off is section it off into four ponytails. So you want... middle part in, or as close to it as you can. This is what I struggle with the girls, because they've got side partings. Getting a neat middle part in takes forever. So, you know, we're not after perfection here. And then just above the ear. Where's your ear? Oh, it's there.
Here.
I can see it. Oops, I just knocked the camera. So, yeah, section it off just above the ear. So you've got one...
the doll,
it
only has one arm.
Got one section of ponytail. And then you're going to want to just put that into a ponytail. So we're going to put that into a ponytail with one of the smaller bands.
Can we play Monopoly today?
Monopoly?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe later. Right, so that is one.
I like it when the curtains are shut.
And then you do the same on the other side.
I like it when the curtains are shut.
Do you?
And the lounge and the light is on, because it makes you feel cozy.
Oh, cozy, but it's nice when it's sunny to have the curtains open, although it's not sunny today.
But still. Well, it's a bit sunny. When we were doing the shed yesterday, it started raining.
It did start raining, yeah.
But we still need a tiny bit.
Right, so then you've got your second ponytail like this. So again, just tie that. So you've got two ponytails. Right, so then you've got two ponytails. Then you want to section this back bit into two as well. His head still? Oh, I just brushed that. It's got a big knot in it. The other day when I was brushing Erin's hair, what did we find in it, Erin?
A choco hoop.
A choco hoop from breakfast. Sorry, because I found a spaghetti hoop on it. Isabel's sock this morning that I put in the wash.
There's a sock outside in the rain.
There's a sock outside in the rain?
Yeah, yesterday.
Now I wonder where all my socks go. They're all over the place.
Outside.
That's where my socks go.
That's why the day I was rinsing away with my hair, it feels like there's something sticking in my hair and I touched it. I couldn't even find anything.
It's all right, because half the time Agnes has honey in her hair, doesn't she? I've got it all tangled up in the brush. There we go. Right, so... Not today, you haven't.
Have you ever tried a hairstyle like Cindy Lou Who?
Oh, I don't know. We'll have to try that at Christmas. Right. So then you've got another ponytail. Oh, sorry, I keep knocking the camera. Another ponytail like that. Another small band in that one. I always use a comb to just try and get it a bit neater. Trying to get the hair down. So this one it's really simple. It looks more complicated than it is, but it's actually quite simple to do. Sometimes I find a hairstyle and I think, oh, that would be really easy. And then when I start doing it, it's really not. Or it doesn't suit the girl's hair. Sometimes, you know, things don't always suit their hair. I find it difficult to do. Because like I said, you know, I'm definitely no expert. And I'm not allowed to cut the kids' hair.
No. Yeah. Type of cut
versus
French.
So Olivia is quite good at cutting hair, and Charlotte cut Joseph's hair, but I am not allowed to cut fringes.
Why?
Because I always mess it up and it ends up being too short. This is why I take you to Jess, because she is a qualified, wonderful hairdresser, and I'm not. Right, so you've got two ponytails at the back, two ponytails at the top. What you're going to do is take this ponytail. Very good. And just do one simple braid. That's all you need to do. Just a simple plait.
Mummy, what is that game that starts
with
an A and then an R and then a T and then an I?
It's Articulate. I'm sure you've played Articulate, maybe not. No. We normally play lots of board games at Christmas, don't we? When we're inside all the time.
Yeah.
Sometimes during the summer holidays.
We've played this game. I want to go on this game.
Yeah.
This game.
No. Oh, wait,
I know which game.
Fortnite.
Right.
I know which
game. Agnes, can you just go and get me a little, just a normal band at the...
Actually,
don't worry about it. It doesn't matter, darling.
I want a big four.
Right. Then you've got this plait here. I was going to tie the end off, but I don't have enough bands in here. So you're going to take it over to this side and tie it in to this ponytail. So you've crossed it over and tie it in to that ponytail. I mean, you'd literally just be taking the band out anyway, but sometimes it's easier, you know, if you don't feel like you've got enough hands to tie it up and then just take it out. So then you've got that over there. Because the girl's hair is not very thick, I like to just pull out the plait a little bit. So literally just take little sections of it and just loosen it off a bit. It just makes it look a little
I'm
bit
doing simple high-end cow.
A little bit thicker.
I love watching Nativity at Christmas.
I know.
It's one of the best films.
Keep your head still for me, darling?
Yeah.
Good girl.
It's one of the best films.
Right, so I just pull it out a little bit just to make it look a little bit thicker. Right. Then what you're gonna do is this ponytail here. Let me give it a quick brush through. You get your hook. And you put it through the plait. Just like that. Take one section of the hair. So you probably want enough for about, what, one, two, maybe five or six. So take one section of the hair. Put it through like that. And then literally pull it through the plait. Like so. Put it into the next bit of the plait.
When you're doing it, like, so you get this ring and then put it through the hole.
Yeah. Put that through like that.
And then put it in. And then put it in.
Keep your head still for me, darling. And then pull it through like that. And you just literally do that all the way down. Pull it through.
You know, in the summer, if we have a big pool, like, I want to get like all like floaties, like foam mats that you can jump on and jump.
Oh, wow. How big do you think a pool is going to be in the garden?
I don't know.
We live in Nick. Maybe we'll go to the actual swimming pool for that.
Yeah.
No, that would be a better
idea. Pool.
Maybe Agnes would like to go swimming for her birthday.
Yeah,
would you like to do the pool thing again for your birthday, Agnes?
I would.
And when we, you know, when we hired the pool that time and went swimming,
Agnes,
all of the family.
Agnes,
for your birthday.
One.
Yeah, would you like to do that?
Agnes, would you like on your birthday?
Well, in Mossy
Mouth. Yeah.
Would you like to on your birthday? Do you want to try to do a different pool, like the Elgin swimming pool?
Right,
so what are we?
Second. Right, so you've got all of those bits going through, and then all you do, I'm just going to pull them all through properly, is put them into this ponytail. I'm going to move that plait up a little bit.
My head.
Sorry. What do I do with that other band? There it is. Put them into that ponytail. Like that.
Have you done it?
Nearly. A little bit of a knee up. No, I don't need to plait it.
I would like to go there for my birthday.
Yeah?
To the Elgin swimming pool or the Lossy one?
Lossy one. A private one. Like we used to do.
So then, all I do with the wax stick, turn around and look at me a minute, darling.
I'm in my class, in my swimming class, used to go to the Elgin swimming pool.
I want to go to Elgin swimming pool for Elgin's birthday.
So sometimes I do use hairspray on the girls' hair for school, especially because
they'll
just
get messy.
To keep nits away, they don't like hairspray.
Right.
And just to keep it nice and neat, but I'll tend to use a wax dip or something at the weekends because I'm not. Try not to use too much hairspray on the hair at the weekends to give it a break. Turn around. Just the wax stick is great for just little flyaway bits.
The flies don't get in your hair.
Not all flies, like the bits that all fly away. You have got a few flyaways there.
Where?
Just on your hair. So that, you can then, if you want to, you can finish it off with some bows if you want to, or some little clips or something if you want to. You can pull it out a little bit more just to make it look a bit thicker. Yeah, that's it. That's pretty much it. I don't know what to call it, but it looks nice. What do you think? Turn around. Yeah, nice.
Yeah.
You could, if you wanted to, turn around again. She's got some little flyaway bits there, but you could, if you wanted to, twist those bits as you're putting them through. As I said, the girls have got quite fine hair, so they don't end up with very much, although it's not a lot. Yeah, like it.
Yeah,
there you go. Right, so that's it. I'm going to keep doing these because they're quite good fun. Do you think?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I got this puzzle from the pool party.
She did have that from the pool party. So I'm going to, obviously, I do my hair reels on a school morning because I don't have much time on a school morning, so it's literally a quick kind of reel. But I'm going to try and do some more of these tutorials at the weekends.
I'm
going to eat the button. I'm not. I'm going to try and film some more of these different tutorials, and I'm going to do some braiding ones, even though I'm not wonderful at braiding or anything, because I literally had no clue how to French braid or Dutch braid. Yeah, I was never, you know, I didn't really get taught how to French braid or Dutch braid or anything. I literally watched it on and tried to figure it out through videos. And is that all the paper just gone on the floor?
Yeah,
I thought so. The paper has fallen on the floor. It's all right, you can just try and put it back in, it'll be fine. Yeah, it's just learnt through videos, and I still find it quite tricky. And sometimes, especially with French and Dutch, I get confused, and then sometimes it ends up being both. But yeah, definitely going to keep on doing these. So I hope you've enjoyed the video, guys. Don't forget to drop us a like, and don't forget it is free to subscribe. So just go ahead and do it. It'd be great. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye.